My name is Brian Asher-Alhadda. Over the course of this short video, I'd like to introduce you to Bel Canto opera. Let's do that by examining four key characteristics: vocal pedagogy and strides made during the Bel Canto period in opera history that developed the vocal classification system we know today. We'll talk about characteristics of Bel Canto melody. And then we'll examine common scenarios of plot and setting. And finally, I'd like to introduce you to the Bel Canto Orchestra.
What exactly is Bel Canto opera? In order for us to get a good idea of that, let's talk about vocal characteristics, melodic characteristics, dramatic characteristics, and we'll talk about what makes up the Bel Canto Orchestra. Bel Canto opera was an Italian movement that roughly took place between 1805 and 1830. However, during that time period, grand opera of France and Germany was taking place. Russian opera was just at its beginning. Later on, we'd have Verismo opera and Wagnerian opera as well. In Bel Canto singing, we use the voice in its most efficient way to reach the soul. There's less focus on story and setting, and that's coupled with an economy of means regarding staging and orchestration. All of this in order for the singers and the audience to focus as much attention as possible on the voice and its ability to use sound and color for conveying drama and emotion of the story. There's a care and method of vocal production using the entire vocal apparatus. The placement of the voice is done so in the most efficient way in order to resonate and project to the fullest degree. Emphasis on traditional Italian speaking manner is also an important aspect of Bel Canto production. Using the voice in the traditional Italian speaking manner involving fine phrasing, notes sustained evenly at length in command of gradations, and clear enunciation. Finally, with regards to tone quality, we try to achieve legato, a perfect, smooth, even production throughout the range. There's a use of light tone in higher registers and the ability to produce an agile, flexible, and athletic sound. Roundness of tone, clear registration, and elevation. Bel Canto opera involves a lot of coloratura and ornamentation and approaches to doing that. Let's try and decipher the differences between the two. Ornamentation and coloratura are carry-ons from the classical era and Baroque periods in music history. Coloratura is an extended athletic virtuosity. It's showy, it's ornamental. There are runs and divisions in vocal and instrumental music that indicate a florid dexterity. But what's important to remember is that coloratura is something the composer writes out and notates, whereas ornamentation is improvisation, the art of creating music spontaneously during the performance. Performer added period characteristic ornamentation, something the composer does not write out, something that's created on the spot and in general is much shorter. So with coloratura, it's written out and it's longer. With ornamentation, it's done on the spot and it's not written out. The Bel Canto period also introduces a renaissance on teaching of voice or vocal pedagogy. We have treatises written on voice, exercises aimed at enhancing vocal dexterity, range, and control. We have the formal identification of three distinct vocal registers, for example, the chest, passaggio or throat, and the head. And new voice classifications expand and more closely define the vocal instrument. No longer are we anchored to merely soprano, alto, tenor, or bass, but the range of vocal description and classification widens greatly. When it comes to Bel Canto melodies, composers were concerned with writing beautiful melodies at all costs, primarily diatonic with an economy of chromaticism, long, slow-growth, linear movements that forecast a sense of forward direction, or short, humorous, folk-like, simple melodies. More often than not, rich, lush, and gorgeous melodies. Common plot characteristics involve an economy of special effects, pastoral settings, historical themes and characters, oftentimes based on classic stories, including Shakespeare, or romantic novel inspiration, which is a new thing of the time. You won't find much fairy tale, mythological, supernatural, or exotic inspiration. Plots were more in tune with the romantic literature of the time in Western European settings. An economy of resources that make it easy for us to focus so deeply on the voice of Bel Canto naturally reach into the selection of orchestra Bel Canto composers employed. During a time where orchestras were expanding in size and incorporating more exotic instrumentation all over Europe, bel canto composers chose smaller orchestras, closer to classical period instrumentation, and rarely exceeding 50 total musicians. Between 1805 and 1830, Italy produced several bel canto composers. The three more famous representations of bel canto opera are Vincenzo Bellini, Gaetano Donizetti, and Gioacchino Rossini. And as you can see, each was quite prolific with the amount of operas composed. The following charts highlight the more famous examples from each composer. You may also find it interesting to note which composers were active in France and Germany as well. And the following chart displays the operas that were being composed alongside bel canto opera. Vincenzo Bellini was born in Catania, Sicily. He was a child prodigy from a highly musical family, and it has been said that he could sing at 18 months. He began studying music theory at 2, the piano at 3, and by the age of 5 he was playing quite well. His first 5 pieces were composed when he was just 6 years old. With a stipend from the municipal government of Catania, Bellini left in 1819 to study at the Naples Conservatory. From 1827 to 1833 he worked in Milan, where all doors were open to him. He sparked immediate controversy in the press with a new style of restless harmonic shifts venturing into remote keys. The next 5 years were triumphant, with his greatest works, La Sonnambula, or The Sleepwalker, Norma, and I Puritani. However, unfortunately, his life was cut short to premature death. He died in Puteaux, near Paris, of an acute inflammation of the intestines. Gaetano Donizetti was the youngest of 3 sons, born in 1797 in the provincial North Italian town of Bergamo. His family was very poor with no tradition of music, his father being the caretaker of the town pawn shop. Donizetti wrote his first opera just before his 19th birthday, Il Pigmalione, which was not premiered until 1960. He wrote 75 operas in the space of just 12 years, and most unusually popular successes, but the critics were often unimpressed. His comedy L'Isir d'Amore, or The Elixir of Love, produced in 1832, is deemed one of the masterpieces of the comic opera genre, along with his Don Pasquale, written in 1843. As a conductor, he led the premiere of Rossini's Stabat Mater. Around 1843, Donizetti began to exhibit symptoms of syphilis. After visits from friends, including Verdi, he was sent back to his hometown of Bergamo. After several years in the grips of insanity, he finally died in 1848. Gioacchino Rossini was born into a family of musicians in Pescara along the Adriatic coast of Italy. His best-known works include the operas Il Barbiere di Siviglia, or The Barber of Seville, La Cenerentola, or Cinderella, La Gazza Ladra, The Thieving Magpie, and William Tell. Religious works, his Stabat Mater, and orchestral works, 6 string symphonies. Some characteristically Italian sounds include inspirational comic folk-like short tunes versus longer, more bel canto song-like melodies. The signature Rossini crescendo identifies a common trend in his music, starting slow, then building in speed and instrumentation over a simple, even static, harmonic pedal. He was nicknamed the Italian Mozart, and until his retirement in 1829, he had become the most popular opera composer in history. Thank you for watching this video. I hope this has served as a helpful introduction to bel canto opera. You may wish to press pause and go through the review.